So I am having a new creamer in my coffee today. I'll show you guys what it is. It's so good. Excuse me, honey. Can I get in the fridge? Thanks. It is the Coffee Mate Coconut Cream. I'm not sure if it's like a new flavor or if it's maybe a summer flavor, but it's really good. Come here, honey. Come on. We gotta get you dressed. We're gonna go get your hair cut today. Are you excited? He loves getting his hair cut. I wanted to show you guys real quick like what I put in my diaper bag, just because I'm packing it right now to leave. And I honestly don't have too much in it right now. Here's my phone, my little loopy case on there, and then my keys. And then on this side, I usually put my vlogging camera. Obviously, these are meant for like drinks or bottles or really whatever you want, but that's what I put in there. And then in the front pocket, I usually just put like some lipstick, hand sanitizer. These are some sunglasses. This is the NYX Butter Gloss in Madeline, which is my favorite one. And then some like hand cream. Okay, in this part, I usually just stick my wallet like in this pocket right here. And then over here, I have some water wipes. In here, I have those little sticky mats that you can put on the table like when you go out to eat for the kids. And then I have a pair of Camden's underwear, a pair of pants, like an extra pair, and then like some pull-ups in here. Here's some boogie wipes.
I see the boogie wipes.
You wanna see them? Okay. Don't open them though. And then down here is like those extra straps that go to this diaper bag that you can like hang on your stroller and stuff like that. And do I have anything in here? In here I just have some children's Benadryl because Camden is allergic to tree nuts, so I like to have Benadryl on me. And then this, which I'm not gonna say what it is out loud because Camden will want it, but I have that just for emergency situations when I need one of those. The last thing that I always have to remember to pack, I take out of Alex's little bag that he carries with him when he takes Cam out. I guess you could call this Alex's diaper bag. And that is his EpiPen and some more liquid Benadryl. So we always have to have his EpiPen with us wherever we go because again, he's allergic to tree nuts. And so that is everything that I pack in there. All right, so should we pick out from your pile of clean laundry that mommy has not folded yet? Should we pick out what you wanna wear? Your Mickey jeans or do you wanna wear shorts?
Yeah.
All right, you wanna wear your yellow shorts?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, okay. And then what about this shirt? Okay, I just wanted to show you guys my little outfit of the day really quickly before we head out. I'm surprised I still fit in this Adidas tee. It's a little tight, as you can see, but it is a large, so it still fits the bump at 38 weeks, and then I just have my under-the-belly leggings on. That's the most comfortable right now. Like, the over-the-belly is not that comfortable anymore because of how big I am. It literally, the over-the-belly only goes to, like, here. So I'd rather wear the under-the-belly ones, and these are from Old Navy. I'll link them down below if I can find them. I have, like, a bunch of pairs. And then I have my really comfy little sandals on that I always wear. All right, guys, so we're on the way to go run a few errands. Yes, I'm still pregnant. We're still on baby watch. I went to my 38-week doctor appointment yesterday. I vlogged a little bit like from my phone because I forgot to bring my camera. And I got some interesting news for my OB. I am now 3 centimeters dilated. So she said I'm progressing pretty quickly since last week I was 2 centimeters and the week before that I was 1 and now I'm 3. So it seems like every week I'm dilating 1 more centimeter. So she did say, you know, some women can sit at like 2 or 3 centimeters for weeks, which yes, I've heard that. But she said since it does seem like I'm progressing quickly that she wouldn't be surprised if I went into labor very soon. I also feel like I'm going to, and I wasn't shocked that I was 3 centimeters because I can like feel it. I can feel down there all of the tightening and the pressure and the cramps and everything, and he feels so low that he honestly feels like he's gonna fall out when I'm walking. Like, that's how low he is. So I wasn't surprised that I was 3 centimeters. I'm still 70% efface. So I've been 70% efface now for 3 weeks. That hasn't changed. And I know that apparently is more important than even how much you're dilated. but I'm still 70% effaced, so I don't really know. I'm just trying to have everything prepared and ready to go, like, at any minute, because I know that I literally could start having contractions any minute, or my water could break at any moment. I'm planning to get my nails done today. I'm trying to decide if I'm gonna get a pedicure. A lot of people have told me to go ahead and get it and get, like, that extra foot massage, because that can actually help induce labor naturally, which I've heard, obviously. But I don't know if I want to spend the money on a pedicure, because I don't really need one. I got one, like, a couple weeks ago, and I'm not the kind of girl that gets a pedicure every 2 weeks. Like, I need to get my nails done every 2 to 3 weeks, but pedicures, I can last, like, a month. I'm kind of freaking out a little bit, because I told you guys the plan for when I go into labor, like, who's going to take care of Camden and all that. I told you in one of my previous vlogs that my in-laws are going to watch Camden while I'm delivering. My mom's going to be in the delivery room with Alex and I. She's also going to film the birth. And then once I deliver the baby, she's going to go home, get Camden from my in-laws and take care of him while we're in the hospital. Now, we're kind of running into a little problem, because I told you guys I do think I'm going to go into labor soon. I just feel like I am. I feel like my body is ready. My in-laws are actually going away soon, because it's one of their son's college graduations. So they're going to be away for a few days. So that means my mom most likely will have to watch Camden while we're in the delivery room. And she's not going to be able to be there for the birth or film it. So it's just going to be me and Alex. And I feel bad having Alex film the birth, because I want him to be present in the moment, obviously. And I know he's going to want to be present too. Like, when I gave birth to Camden, he was, like, all up in my business down there, like, watching everything. And I really didn't want him to be. I wanted him to be kind of behind the action and, like, you know, up near where I was. But he wanted to see everything that was going on. That's just how he is. He was very interested. So he was, like, all down there looking at everything. And obviously he's going to want to do that again, I'm sure. And that I'm not going to have that part filmed, obviously. Like, usually when you film the birth and you put it on YouTube, you're kind of, like, up here and you get and you see that kind of picture. So if he were to film it, he'd have to be, like, kind of up here with me, and I would just feel bad that he would miss out on seeing all the action go down. So I don't really know what I'm gonna do yet. I mean, I could find someone to watch cam, but since it is so random when I'm gonna go into labor, that's the problem. So we'll see. Hopefully I go into labor when my in-laws are still in town. Another thing I wanted to mention was I did set up a date to be induced. I made an appointment. I know I told you guys I decided not to be induced, and I still haven't fully decided if I'm going to actually go through with it. But I was talking to my OB yesterday, and she said you have to make an appointment to be induced a full week in advance. So she said I can go ahead and set up an appointment to be induced next week. She would be the one who would induce me and deliver and everything, which I love because she is my OB. So I wouldn't get anyone else in the practice. I would get my actual OB, which I really like and I feel comfortable with. And I would be 39 weeks and something days at that point. And she said that's totally fine to deliver my baby. She said that he is fully developed and everything, and it would be a super easy induction just because I'm already 3 centimeters dilated, 70% effaced. Like, she said I'm pretty much ready to go, so the induction would not be hard at all. It would be super easy. So anyway, she said to go ahead and make the appointment, and then if I want to cancel it, I can. She said even up to the day before, I can go ahead and cancel it, and it's not a big deal. So I figured, why not just make it? Just to have it, you know what I mean? Like, next week, if I'm still pregnant, I could be super, super miserable. And I could, like, wish that I had that appointment made. So I went ahead and made it, you guys. And I don't know if I'm really gonna go through with it. I came home and I told Alex that I made the induction appointment, and he was like, oh no, go ahead and cancel it. Like, you're not getting induced. Like, he really doesn't want me to be induced. He wants Quentin to come when he wants to come. Thank you. Which I totally understand that, and I honestly want him to come naturally too, but then again, you know, he doesn't understand how I feel at all. My doctor even said that usually when people go ahead and make the appointment to be induced, that's when they actually go into labor naturally, so we'll see. The heartbeat was 140, which is what it has been for the past few weeks. I've remained the same weight, so I'm still 145, which I was last week as well. And I think that is pretty much everything that happened at my 38 week prenatal appointment yesterday, but yeah, I'm 38 weeks currently and one day. And last night, you guys, I literally thought I was going into labor. Like, I know she did the cervical check, which I don't know if that like can cause anything, but I started like having small tiny contractions that were super irregular. They weren't consistent, but they were like small contractions and like tightening down there. And I really thought like I was gonna go into labor last night or maybe even like overnight, but here I am today. It is almost 12:30 and I am, you know, obviously not in labor, not having contractions or anything like that. I feel fine today. I mean, obviously I still feel the pressure and everything like that, but I really haven't been having those like contractions or anything since last night. Look at me. You did such a good job, honey. And you got a little new car. You were such a good boy in there. Come on, hun.
Going down.
Okay, so I just got home from getting my nails done and I asked you guys on Instagram what color to get. So many of you said to get like a baby blue or like a teal or a light sage green, which I actually really wanted to do, but my salon didn't have that big of a color selection because I do get dip powder and they didn't have a light sage green. So I was kind of sad about that. But a baby blue I actually got when I was in labor with Camden, so I didn't want to get that again. So I went with nude and I really like it. I don't know if you guys can really see the color because it kind of blends in with my skin, but I think when it grows out a little, it'll look even better. And since I probably honestly am not going to be able to get my nails done for a while after I have Quentin, I'm glad I went with nude because when nude does grow out, it doesn't look bad. But I do think it's a really pretty color. I love that it's just neutral, it will go with everything, and I love that it has sparkle in it too. I'm not sure if you guys can see that. I don't remember the brand of the SNS powder, but the color was Quiet Calm. And then when I got home, I had two packages. I made an order at Sephora because I'm not sure if it's still going on, but they've been having a VIB sale. So if you're one of their rewards members, you can either get 10, 15, or 20% off depending on like the level you are. And I got a few things that I want to show you guys I'm really excited about. And then I also got an order in from DSW. I got some new sneakers. They're so freaking cute. I'm like obsessed with them. I had so many coupons to DSW that I ended up getting like, I feel like $40 off or something like that. It was crazy. Okay, so first I picked up this Bobbi Brown Crushed Liquid Lip. And my girlfriend Nina, she does my lashes, brows, tan, like all of that. She also is a makeup artist and she introduced me to this and it's beautiful. It is like the prettiest nude and it's so moisturizing. And I got the color Lychee Baby. It's very shiny too, but it is a liquid lipstick. And then I went ahead and I picked up this Tatcha Silk Canvas Primer. Again, my friend Nina used this on me when she did my makeup one time and I was like obsessed with it. So I got the small version because the big version is super expensive. I just got like the small one. I can't even explain the consistency of it, but it feels amazing on your skin and it makes your makeup look flawless. I am not even kidding. And the last thing that I picked up from the Sephora sale was this Becca palette. It's the Chloe and Malika one. It has highlight, two blushes, and then the bronzer. And this is the Malika one. They also have a Chloe one, but I heard the Malika one is better and the colors are just more vibrant. I think the Chloe one like is super, super light and doesn't really show up on the skin. But I think this is so beautiful. I haven't tried it out yet, but I'm really excited about it. So here are the shoes I picked up from DSW. I'll link all this stuff down below if you guys are interested. But how cute are these shoes? I was pretty much obsessed because they're like white and nude and cream with some like taupe. And I couldn't get over the color. I don't remember what these are called. But again, I'll find them and like link them down below. I think they're pretty new though. Because there were like no reviews online for this color when I ordered them. So I think they're like a brand new color, I wanna say. So also, not only did I get my nails done for labor and delivery, hopefully, but I also got a foot massage. So a lot of people have been telling me to go get a really good foot massage and that will help induce labor. So my girl said she could just do a foot massage. So she did like a 10-minute foot massage. It felt so relaxing. So even if it doesn't induce me, it was totally worth it because it was so relaxing. And I know there's like certain pressure points, I think I read, between like the ankle or the ankle bone and like the foot or something. There's certain pressure points that they're supposed to like massage and stuff. And she did massage that area for a little bit. So hopefully she knew what she was doing, because I told her I was trying to get this baby out. Can I have a kiss? Can I have a kiss? Can I have a kiss, please?
Let me think about it.
Can I have a kiss, please?
Think about it.
How long do you have to think about it?
3 minutes.
3 minutes?
Uh-huh. 4 more minutes.
4 more minutes?
Uh-huh.
Mwah.
No. No! I said 4 more minutes.
Oh, okay, sorry. 4 minutes. All right. I did want to show you guys my 38-week belly. So that is what it looks like right now. It's definitely low. Like, you can see how low that is. And my belly button is like so pointy because it hasn't fully popped out, but like the top skin has. It's so weird looking. It's freaking me out. So I'm gonna show you guys what I am making for dinner. So I'm marinating a flank steak right here for about an hour, and the sauce I used was this Allegro original marinade. I've never tried this before, but I found it in the grocery store and figured I would give it a try. It smells really good. So that's what I'm marinating, and then I'm going to, I always just get the pre like cut and packaged broccoli. It's just so much easier. So I'm gonna throw this in the oven with some olive oil, salt, and pepper and just roast it for a little bit. And then I'm also making some baked potatoes. Okay guys, I think I'm gonna go ahead and end the vlog here. Mama's out of breath, mama needs a break. I'm gonna go ahead and cook dinner and edit the rest of the night, I think, so I can get this up at some point tomorrow for you guys. Please let me know any tips down below how to self-induce labor, because I am ready at this point. So let me know your tips down below, and thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you, well, I might see you in the next vlog.